Now we will see the arithmetic subtraction. First, let's see the decimal subtraction. Take two numbers, 1039, 2019, 1126. Here the base is. While doing any subtraction, here the base value is nothing but the borrow value. So the borrow is also 10 in decimal subtraction. Here, first, while performing subtraction, we need to check which number is greater, which number is smaller. Here, this number is greater, this number is smaller. This is greater. So the result we are getting is a positive number because subtracting low number from a high number. So perform the subtraction. 9 minus 6 is 3. 3 minus 2 is 1. 0 minus 1 we can't perform because 0 is less than 1. So we need to take the borrow. So we will take the borrow from the previous value, previous digit. So the borrow is 10. And here this value will be 1. So we'll add these two digits. So 10 plus 0 is 10, 10 minus 1 is 9. Next 1 minus 1 is 0. This is the decimal subtracted value. We'll see another 1036 01 20 0.31 0.10. Take this as high value. Subtract these two values. These are of base 10 because of decimal. This is the high value and this is the low value. Subtracting low value from high value result in a positive number. Subtract 1 minus 3. 1 minus 3 we cannot subtract because 1 is less than 3. So we will take the borrow from previous bit. If the borrow is 10 and this value is 2, 10 plus 1 is add these two numbers. 10 plus 1 is 11, 11 minus 3 is 8. Next 2 minus 1 is 1 point. This is 6 minus 0, 6, 3 minus 2, 1, 0 minus 1. We cannot perform because 0 is less than 1. So we will take the borrow from previous bits. The borrow is 10. So this value will be 0. So 10 plus 1, 10 plus 0 is 10, 10 minus 1 is 9. So 0 minus 0 is 0. This we are getting a positive value. Let's see the binary subtraction. Subtract these two numbers. Here this before doing a subtraction, first check which number is greater, which number is smaller. Check the MSB digits, the MSB values are same. So take the next digit of the MSB, 0, this one, this is greater, this is smaller. So the value that you are getting will be negative after subtraction. So first I will take the positive value, next this is 1, this is 0. After subtraction, 1 minus 0 is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0, 1 minus 0, 1, 1 minus 0, 1, 1 minus 1 is 0. This is the positive value. 1011 1101. First check which number is positive. Here we are, MSBs are same, so next value of MSB is 1, here is 0. This value is greater, this value is smaller. So the value we are getting is negative. So first, instead of doing this, we will subtract 1101 minus 1011. Here the value is greater, here the value is smaller. After subtracting, here we will get a positive number, but here we are doing opposite of this, so the value will be negative. So here 1 minus 1 is 0. The 0 minus 1 we cannot do because 0 is less than 1. That means we need to take the bar. Each subtraction bar is nothing but base of binary is 2. Here 0 minus 1 is we cannot do. So that the base value will be 2. Which means bar. So cancel 1. And here we will this is the 0. 2 plus 0 is 2. 2 minus 1 is 1. 0 minus 0, 0. 1 minus 0, 0. The value we are getting is 0110. That is minus 0010. If you want to verify, you can also verify. 1011 value is, this is 8 plus 8, 4, 2, 1, 8, 9, 10, 11. This is 8 plus 4, 12 and 13. 11 minus 13 is minus 2. Here this value is 8, 4, 2, 1. So this value is 2. So the value we are getting here is minus 2. Now we will see the after subtraction. Let's take the two after numbers. After maximum value is 7, so I will take 7130. After the base is 8. Base is equal to the borrow in subtraction. 1011. Here 0 minus 1 is not possible because 0 is less than 1. So we will take the borrow from previous value. The borrow is 10. This value will be now 2. 10 plus 1, 0. 10 plus 0 is 10. 10 minus 1 is 9. 2 minus 1 is 1, 1 minus 0, 1, 7 minus 1 is 6. This is subtracted octal value. Let us take the fractional value. 3013.21 613. Here I will take this value as 7. Because if we take 3 here, 3 minus 6 is, finally we will get us negative value. So 1, 3. Here 1 minus 3 is not possible because 1 is less than 3. So we will take the borrow from previous bit. This value, borrow is 8. This value will be 1. 8 plus 1, 9. 9 minus 3 is 6. 1 minus 1, 0. 8 minus 3 is not possible, so we will take the borrow from previous bit. In the previous bit also 1 is less than 3, so we cannot take the borrow. Here also 0, 0 is less than 1, we cannot take the borrow. Here this is 7, so we can take the borrow from here. This is 6, we take the borrow here, borrow is 8, here this value is 8. Here this value is, here we will take the borrow from here, so this value will be 7. Here borrow will be 8. So again we will take the borrow from here. This is 7 and this is, here we will get borrow as 8. So in this way we can perform the subtraction for the fractional values. Now we will see the hexadecimal subtraction. Take two digits, 210, 8.3. This is 530. 0.19.2. The 3 - 2 is 1. Here A is nothing but 10. 10 - 9 is 1. 0 - 1 is not possible. So we will take the bar. Here the hexadecimal base is 16. This is bar. Bar is 16. This value will be 0. 16 - 1 is 15. 15 is nothing but F is 15. 0 - 0, 0, 5 - 3, 2. This is the final hexadecimal value. 30F1.11. This is all about the arithmetic operations.